Creatine is one of the most studied and effective supplements for improving athletic performance and building muscle. It's naturally found in small amounts in foods like red meat and fish, and also produced by the body, but supplementing with it can significantly enhance your results, especially if you're engaged in high-intensity workouts like weightlifting, sprinting, or CrossFit. When you take creatine, it increases the phosphocreatine stores in your muscles. This helps produce more ATP, which is the primary energy currency of the body, particularly useful during short bursts of intense activity. One of the biggest benefits people notice is improved strength and power output. That means more reps in the gym, more weight lifted, and better overall performance. Over time, this leads to greater muscle gains. But creatine doesn't just help you perform better, it also helps with recovery. Studies show that it can reduce muscle damage and inflammation after training, which means less soreness and quicker recovery between workouts. Another major reason people love creatine is because it increases muscle hydration. It pulls water into your muscle cells, making them look fuller and more pumped. This cell volumization effect doesn't just make you look good, it also helps trigger muscle growth at a cellular level. And contrary to old myths, this extra water is inside your muscle cells, not under your skin, so it won't make you look bloated. While most people associate creatine with physical performance, its benefits actually go beyond the gym. The brain also uses ATP, and creatine helps replenish that energy source. Some research shows that it can improve memory, focus, and cognitive function, especially under stress or sleep deprivation. It's even being studied for potential benefits in neurological conditions like depression, Alzheimer's, and Parkinson's disease. Now, in terms of safety, creatine is incredibly well researched and considered safe for long-term use in healthy individuals. There's no evidence it harms the kidneys or liver in normal doses. The best and most affordable form is creatine monohydrate. You can do a loading phase where you take 20 grams a day, split into four doses for about 5 to 7 days, or just start with a maintenance dose of 3 to 5 grams daily. Both methods work. The loading phase just saturates your muscles a bit faster. Some people wonder if they need to cycle creatine or take a break from it. The short answer is no, not unless you want to. Your body's natural production will decrease slightly while supplementing, but it goes back to normal once you stop. For most people, daily use is completely fine. Timing doesn't matter too much, but some people prefer taking it post-workout with a meal because insulin helps shuttle it into muscle cells. You can also mix it with your protein shake or just water. It's tasteless and dissolves well, especially if you use warm water. In summary, creatine helps you train harder, recover faster, build more muscle, and may even boost brain function. It's safe, cheap, and effective, which is why it's one of the few supplements that's actually worth taking. Whether you're a serious athlete, a casual gym goer, or just looking for a cognitive edge, creatine is one of the best tools you can have in your supplement stack. If this helped you out, make sure to hit like and subscribe so you don't miss more no-nonsense advice that actually works.